Hey everyone, and welcome back to Breathe Your Words. It is 9 o'clock at night, and I walk in my daughter's room, and they're awake talking, and I told them to go to bed. What is it with children thinking that, well, at least we're in the bed? You know, we technically went to bed, but if we want to keep talking, it's okay. No, it's not. When your parents say go to bed, go to bed. Anyway. So, I want to talk about something else, something here in Israel that is wild. Okay, you guys, both parents have to work here in Israel. It's ridiculous because it's like the Israeli system is set up to where parents are overly exhausted, children are raising themselves, and you basically end up giving into whatever your kids want because you're too tired to deal with it because both of you've been at work all day. It's ridiculous. And then if one parent stays home, it's not enough for the family to live off of one income because the bills and the price of living and the fact of taking care of the children along with providing food for them, it's very expensive. It's very fascinating. It was just a thought I had. I just wanted to share that, you know, because a lot of people don't realize that when people here in Israel say like they don't have enough or they're out of money, most of the time they really mean that. It's a lot of the economy that lives in the negative here in Israel. It's a lot of the economy that lives in a way where, okay, I mean, if I go in the negative 5,000 shekels, it's okay because my check will cover that. And then I'll have about 1,000 left, but then I'm gonna go in the negative again. Literally, it's a terrible cycle that keeps repeating itself. And it's like majority of Israel lives in the negative, and they're okay with that. And it's like mentally, that has to wear on a person mentally, that it's not okay. It's like, how can I put it? It's like you're always drowning and there's no way to get out. You understand? But it's not like that for everyone, but it is like that for people who maybe have one income or, you know, they have one parent working and that's it. That's how that one parent feels or that one spouse feels like. It's just never enough. It's never, you know, and it's like if you're not the type of person that is, you know, positive no matter what, then you'll drown in the stress and the thought of, you know, not being able to provide. And for me, if we have all the necessities, then we're good. But the problem for me also is that if we can't pay the bills, then we're not good. You know, it's like one month you can pay, one month you can't. That it shouldn't be like that. No one wants to live like that on purpose, but people do. There are many situations in life. You know, one thing I could say about being here in Israel is taught me an intense life lesson that everyone doesn't choose to be in the situation they're in. Everyone doesn't choose to be in debt. You know, sometimes that's just the cycle that they're stuck in, and it might just be for that season of their life, not forever. Meaning, eventually they're going to get a better job, or eventually they're going to get better pay, or eventually both spouses will be working and they can make better, which normally happens when all the children are like 10 and above. You know, then it can happen, and you're back set regular again. You don't have to live in the negative. You don't have to struggle, and that's nice. But you know, one thing that Israel has taught me, the life lesson is that we need to step back and actually look at people's situations before we just assume that they are terrible with money or they're terrible with finances, because that's not always the case. So I just want to share that with you guys because I thought about it, and the story about my daughters in the beginning, I just thought I added that in there because they made me angry. I have four girls, and my two oldest ones were supposed to be asleep at 8 o'clock because I have to get them up early in the morning every day, like 5:30 or 6 o'clock sometimes. So if I'm waking them up early, I want them to get adequate sleep for school, you know? So anyway, like I said, you guys, the real moral of this video, the lesson of this video today is that we should not judge a book by its cover, meaning you shouldn't look at somebody who doesn't have money and assume that they're wasteful or they're careless or they're frivolous with their money, because that's not what it always means. There are many things that can hold people back, dealing with dirty landlords, dealing with crooked or corrupt systems, you know, dealing with corrupt people that steal money from you. It could be anything. Or, you know, credit cards that maybe you used it in the wrong way and you weren't even sure how to use it right. All those things happen. You know, sometimes it could be a family member got sick and you had to pay for that, and that put you in the minus. Anything can put you in the minus. Anything can create a setback. But everybody in this life is not promised every day to have it great all the time. But even though we're not promised every day to have it great all the time, one thing that I know keeps me great on the inside is Christ Jesus. And so if he's not your Lord and Savior, I pray that he becomes your Lord and Savior because he is mine and he definitely pours peace into me when there's chaos going on all around me. So you guys, with that being said, have a blessed night. Thank you for watching. And remember, don't judge a book by its cover because you don't want to be judged by your cover, you know. Have a blessed night. Thank you. Oh, one more thing. Please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. And share if you enjoyed this video.